Hi everybody, I'm going to do a session for Esha today, and I'm just going to read over her intentions for the journey. So she wants to release trauma around her throat and sacral chakras. She also wants to find out the purpose of being here on earth and to start making progress on her spiritual psychic career. And she wants lots of clarity around that, to be able to speak without any shudder in complete clarity, to be able to handle emotions such as deep insecurity, resentment towards self, others, jealousy, and non-acceptance with more ease of heart. So this is going to be a 30-minute session. So it's really difficult to say what the journey is going to be about, but it's going to be based around that. And it's going to be what she needs at this specific time in her life. I always say that because that's a lot of stuff to go over. However, it's what she wants to work towards. So I'm just going to take a couple of deep breaths and integrate in a journey, because 30 minutes goes by pretty quick. I actually have vision just come right to me right off the bat. Is a slalom skier going down the hill, going between these poles, really like super fast. And then I see another person sitting at the top of a really, 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 really steep drop. And the person is looking down at the slalom skier going through these slaloms like crazy. And she's a relatively new skier, so she wants to be able to jump right in there, full feet, go crazy. But it's like, it's really steep and far straight down. It's almost like you're jumping off a cliff going down this really, really steep thing before you're really ready to do it. And but she's wanting to do it and she's teetering on the edge and says, should they do it or should they not do it? And so she goes for it and she takes her poles and sticks them into the snow and pushes herself right off, and she goes down really like, it's like literally there's no, it's straight down, so it almost like it goes in this way, so she's going off a cliff. And she's dropping straight down and she hits the snow, and then she starts to lose her balance and then turns into a big snowball. It's like you see in the shows, and it's going right down the snowball and then smashes down into the wall on the bottom of the hill, into the ski place, the ski hut, or whatever you want to call it. And she's disorientated and she goes, well, what happened? And the slalom skier looks at her and she kind of raises one eyebrow and she says, how many times have you skied? And she starts counting them on her fingers, and the slalom skier said, I wouldn't even attempt that, and I've been skiing for my whole life. And she sits down in front of the girl and says, sometimes you need to have patience in order to be able to achieve goals like that. Otherwise, you can mess yourself up. So she's basically saying, you're lucky you actually came out of this in one piece. Because a lot of people would go that and get really hurt, if not kill themselves, because generally not kill themselves because it's not that super dangerous. But the idea is saying, and before you can ski like that, And like me, you have to have patience and really practice in order to become really good at doing exactly what I'm doing. And that's okay. It just takes time. You can't expect to be able to be an Olympic skier right off the bat. It takes time. It takes a lot of work, patience, repetitiveness. Like to do the same thing over and over and over again and keep better and better and better and better in yourself. And this person's going, but, and it's like a lot of buts, but, and it's like, the key here is what this person is saying to you is that, yes, I understand, you know the principles. However, you need to be able to put the principles into practice, and then you're going to find out that those principles might not work with you. You might have to modify them. You might have to change them. You might have to do this and that and this to get them to work exactly the way you want them to work, in the way that works best with yourself. I could teach you how I ski, but you might not be able to ski exactly like me, because it takes time and practice, and you're going to find that you have to modify the way you were taught in order to be able to be the best that you can be in skiing, for instance. But that goes with everything in life. You can't dive off a mountain and expect to fly. You're going to have to build wings. You're going to have to build a jetpack. You're going to have to put a parachute on. You're going to have to do something to help you get to the bottom of the mountain. Or you climb down the mountain. But if you jump off a mountain, you're not going to end. It's not going to end well for you. It's like, you could simply say that I want to be able to fly. So how can you fly? As in this physical world, how can we fly? We have to take planes, you have to use something in order to help us. But you keep insisting, well, I know I can fly. Everything is energy, I can fly. But what is stopping you from flying? It's the memories and the belief over thousands and thousands of years that humans cannot fly. Gravity takes over and you will fall to your death if it's high enough. So in theory, in the physical world, we cannot fly. But then there's people saying, no, we can fly because we're energy. We can. Why can't we fly? Well, we could throw gravity back into play again. But gravity is an illusion. Like, there's almost like this argument that's going on. But. And I think what it's switching to now is a man that is fishing. He has a very thin line. And then there's another person that's fishing with exactly the same fishing pole, exactly the same fishing reel, exactly the same fishing line. And one man, and you both catch the fish at the same time. And one man is reeling in like this, really ridiculously fast, nonstop. This is taking it in all the way. The other person puts the drag on, takes his time, and this person snaps the line and loses the fish. This person takes 2 hours to get that fish in. And I know that's exaggerated a bit, but that's what it's basically saying. It would take this man 2 hours because it's such a big fish, tires the fish out and slowly brings it in and never loses the fish, but gets the fish in the end. Because he had to have patience. He had to use his tools to the best of his ability. He just couldn't rush into it and reel it in right off the bat and become really, really, really good overnight. It took time, it took patience in order to get that fish. That was two messages based around the same ideas that you're meant to hear before I do anything else. It's important you understand the concept. It's not saying you don't, but sometimes the spirit world wants you to listen to it in that way to help you understand a few things you need to work on. It's not meant to be taken personally. It's meant to be constructive. And there's a big difference between destructive and non-destructive. Criticizing, abusing, and that's not what this is about. It's about constructive criticism. If I don't like to use criticism, I like to use it to tell you that it's constructive learning. And it's important that you understand constructive learning and be able to hear it and be able to work with it, because that's how the spirit realms work through you. They will show you things in order to bring you to a specific direction. And sometimes it's always constructive, but sometimes they're going to be telling you things that you might not want to completely take 100% literally. That's one of the hardest lessons to learn as a spiritual journeyer, is to look at the feelings of things. And that's sometimes more important than the visual aspect of things. Each one is very important because it teaches us something. It also brings us into a specific direction. It opens up our subconscious mind to activate something within ourselves in order to bring us down a specific path. But not everything they say is going to be 100% exactly what it is that you think, because you're interpreting an energy. But they're also telling you that, I mentioned this before in many journeys, is that you might end up becoming a doctor, but you might start off as an astronaut, then a cook. But we know in most cases, it's you want to be a doctor, you have to start pretty early, and because it's so long. But the idea is, just because you want to become a doctor doesn't mean you won't have to do other things to get you the things you need to do in order to become a doctor. And they might tell you that you're going to be an astronaut, and you go towards that direction, and that eventually will bring you towards being a doctor. But you would have to go that direction first, because the things that you needed to learn along the way, that the only way you could learn them is to try to become an astronaut. I'm looking at yourself, and you say you want your sacral chakra and also your throat. I'm looking at both of those. I'm going to lie you down on a table. And one of the things that you want is clarity. And clarity of thought comes with patience. When you're patient, things become more clear. It's when you're not patient, when you want things done right away, is when clarity gets overthrown by all the things that you want to do and accomplish. The best way to get clarity of thought is to be patient, and how we love that word, patience. When every time you say that, you cringe, and you're not alone, because patience is something that is so ridiculously important, but is also so ridiculously annoying to hear, because we always hear it. But what does it mean to be patient? It means that we have to be able to go through a learning one thing at a time, or many things at a time, depending on what type of learning it is. But we need to be able to accept what we know at this time and what is happening at this time, to acceptance of that, the movement of that. Sometimes is slow, sometimes is fast. So the acceptance of the situation teaches us patience, waiting. It's the same thing as acceptance. So it all goes hand in hand. If we accept what is going on in our life, that this is what needs to be at this moment, doesn't mean we don't want to change it tomorrow, because we can change it tomorrow. It just means that we're in acceptance of our situation right now, because you cannot be not accepting, because reality is, that is actually happening right now. So how can you not accept that? You might not like it, and you might want to change it, but that's not the same thing as accepting. I lay you down on the table, and I like to do this first, especially when I'm dealing with chakras and clearing and healing. I start off with your feet and start off at the top of your head, and I start going through here, and I watch the hands go down like this. When they move them down the body, I have energy flowing out, and I see where the energies need to go inside the person. Because sometimes what we think we need to heal is not necessarily what needs to happen first. Sorry, and they want me to do two chakras, the extreme top and extreme bottom. So it's your grounding and just your crown is really, really, really important that they do both of these. And that also includes everything above, everything around you, everything that you wanted, but your throat isn't where it's wanting to hit yet, because part of the problem might think it's your throat, but extreme feet, the grounding part, you're not grounded correctly. It's literally, when I do this, I get the extreme, my energy goes to the feet and to the top of the head. And then it just does that. It's just what it wants to do. And that has to be energized first, and then I can move towards your throat. I'm starting off with your feet, because your feet, you need to ground yourself. It's extremely important. And I'm taking out, literally, I don't know why, I literally have these, like, they look like pins, literally, and I'm sticking these in your feet. They're not pins, they're like pins, but they're very, very long, and they grow. As soon as they stick them in, for instance, if you stick it in the bottom of your foot, it grows into the ground. And I'm doing this with each toe all down the foot. So you got like 20 or 30 of these things in each one of your feet. And it pulls you up, it pulls it and grows in the ground and puts you straight up in the air. There's all this stuff growing around your feet, and your legs become roots of a tree. And literally from your waist down is, your feet become two tree trunks, and all this energy goes way, 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 way deep down into the earth, and they dwindle into the part just above the core, and it pulls energy from the core up into your body. And your legs glow really, really, really bright, and your legs don't look like tree trunks anymore. They just look like beautiful glowing legs, and they're glowing super, super bright, and they're staying glowing. And now at the same time, I'm calling upon the sun to send energy through the top of your mind, straight down through here into your mind, all the way into your heart. And this as well is coming up your legs through your body, through your vertebrae, back into, both of them are going up your vertebrae, one's coming down, one's going up, and they enter through into your heart. So you get this beautiful energy of light coming from above, entering in into your mind, down your spinal cord, and in through the back. So you have this like two energies that going in like this, one from above and one from behind, through your vertebrae, and it's creating a ball of light at the part where they're intersecting. So this is your heart right here, and the energy is coming down on like this and coming in like this, and there's a gap there that is a beautiful ball of light. This is important though, and because everything has to be connected, and this is a part of the connecting. As you're doing that, it creates an actual like an oval, and it starts to spin a lot and pulls this ball into your heart, and there's a big, huge, beautiful light that appears, like it grows outward like this. And you kind of slump over for a second, and then you start to rise off the ground. And everybody thinks grounding has to be touching the ground. No, grounding is all about your energy, and it has to flow in a certain specific way. So when you're grounded, it means that your feet are firm. Like it's like there's roots always there, but they don't have to be physically grounded to the earth. It just means you have to have your energy grounded into the earth. Even at the time, you could be flying all over the place, but you're still grounded. You still have those energy cords that are connect yourself to the earth, into that specific plane. But you might not even see them, you might not even feel them, but they have to be there. The idea and the intention needs to be there. You need to be able to ground, and that will give you focus and clarity. Grounding is super important to have clarity, because if you're not grounded, your mind goes crazy, your emotions go all over the place. Grounding brings everything into balance. And if you filter everything through your heart, it also creates balance. We're not near done here yet, because this is coming in. Now there's a big, beautiful glow around your heart. And this energy comes in and like comes up and enters into your heart. But there's no separation. One goes down into the earth, but it goes through your heart down into the earth. The other one goes up through your heart, up into your mind. I call upon Arcturians to come to me right now. And you're glowing really, really, really bright, and you have this beautiful light coming in from the top of your head and going down into the ground, and you have this beautiful, vibrant light around your heart, and you're suspended into that state. There's a male and female come forward, and I see them as beings of the robes. These specific two, the robes are right to the ground, and they almost like they don't actually walk. They're more like floating. It's really strange, but that's how I see them right now. And they float over to you. One goes in behind you. The female is in behind you, and the male stands in front of you. So you're in the center like this, and there's a male Arcturian here and a female here, and they both touch your heart from both sides. And the heart was really bright white, and now it turns into a pink color at the back and a blue color at the front. And when they merge together, they start to flow and move and turn and go. One light goes straight up, and one goes straight down. And so you have this pink light to go straight up and the pink light to go straight down. But the heart is merged with both these lights, both colors. And they're humming a specific sound. It's like, they're making that, it has like an echoey sound, because there's a harmonic to it when they're both doing it, and when they're making that sound, it actually merges both lights together, and it's really quite beautiful. And your third eye starts to glow really, really, really bright as well. All your chakras start to grow. You start to cough up something out of your throat, and it's like you're cough up a beetle, and then more beetles come out. All these bugs start coming out of your mouth. Arcturians touch your throat with their fingers. One on each side, and they touch the front. And their fingers are glowing red. And the vibrations go. And your throat glows really, 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 really red. It like starts to expand outward like this. And you got this, you want to, this huge red ball comes out of your mouth. And Arcturians take that ball and they set it, like they both walk over with it and they look at the ball and they start to, again, make sounds. And the sounds are super high pitched. It's almost, I could never reproduce it. It's ridiculously high pitched and the ball shatters. And the glass from this ball fall to the ground. And you're coughing still. I touch your throat. And my hand glows really bright yellow. Sun no hiente. I draw a letter Y. No run. I take a tuning fork and I touch, like, have a little metal, and I hit it, and it creates like this tuning fork inside yourself to vibrate in a very beautiful frequency. Both Arcturians look at you. They smile. They have a book. They place it in the palm of your hand and take your other hand and place it on the top, and it glows really bright and it goes inside your arms, like inside your forms into your heart. And they say you cannot run until you crawl, then walk, and then run. We'll help you grow and expand. But they say there is still work to do. There is always things to do. And you are right where you need to be at this moment in time. And you must believe that. The acceptance and the belief that things are the way they are meant to be is really important in order to grow in spirituality. The acceptance of how things are. Acceptance of yourself when you look in the mirror. The love of oneself is acceptance of what you see, and a belief that you are exactly what you're meant to be. You look exactly where you're meant to look. You speak exactly the way you're meant to speak. No. Well, Asha, that's what was meant to be shared for you at this time. And there's always things to do. There's always things to work on. That is the message that was given to you at this time. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful day. If you have any questions, just ask. And we'll we'll see what we can do to best answer those questions. Have a wonderful day. Take care.